Dear students, welcome to EPG Badasala. I am Dr. V. Chandra Kumar, Associate Professor, Department of Library and Information Science, University of Madras, Chennai. I am going to present the module Communication Theories and Models, which comes under the paper Knowledge Society. This module is in two parts. Part 1 traces the evolution of communication theories and outlines the major theories of communications, and part 2 proceed to describe the different types of communication models and demonstrate the major models of communications. The word communication has a rich history. Human race has communicated through different techniques and methods. They use sound, gesture, sign languages, some of the methods of communication used by early human beings. The word communicate is derived from the Latin verb communicare, adjective communius, and old French adjective commune. The key root is mum and not uni, stemming from the Latin word munus, meaning to share publicly or impart or make common. Communication is thus traced back to be derived from the old French term communication and Latin word communication. This clearly only means to share and are common to all. The word enters into the English language during 14th and 15th century. The term originally meant sharing of tangible goods like food, goods, and property. Today, it is applied to knowledge, information processed by living things or computers. Communication is the exchange and flow of information and ideas from one person to another. It involves a sender transmitting an idea, information, or feeling to the receiver. Communication is a two-way process of reaching mutual understanding in which participant not only exchanging ideas, feelings, and information, but also create and share meaning. There are 8 components of communication. These are source, sender, channel, receiver, destination, message, feedback, and context. Source is which produce a message. Sender refer to transmitter which operates on the message in same way produce a signal suitable for transmission over the channel. Channel is the medium used to transmit the signal. Receiver perform the inverse operation of that done by transmitter, reconstructing the message from the signals. Destination is the person or thing for to whom the message is intended. Message, it refers to the concept, information, communication, or statement that is sent in a oral, graphic, written, audio, visual, audiovisual form to the recipient. Feedback is the loop of making a two-way communication process relate to respond to the message. It is simply the reaction of the destination back to the source, either it may be direct or indirect. The context, it refers to the background and the environment. It may be immediate and far. Space and time play a larger role of a given communications. In other 3 elements in the process of communications are associated with it. These are entropy, redundancy, and noise. Entropy is a measure of amount of uncertainty associated with content or message. Redundancy is something excess or unwanted data comes with a message. Redundancy either entered in the communication process knowingly or unknowingly. If deliberate, it serves the purpose of reiterating the message, and otherwise receptiveness is undesired elements. Noise is actually anything irrelevant, unwanted, undesired, and hence a disturbance or interference to the effective transmission process. Noise can be physical, semantic, or psychological. It can be disturb the communication process at any point. It can be associated with any elements. Human communications may be broadly categorized into the following types. The first one is intrapersonal communication. The next one is interpersonal communication. The third one is group dynamics. The fourth one is public or mass communication. The fifth one is organization. The sixth one is cross-culturals. When you come to intrapersonal communications, communicate oneself. When you come to interpersonal communications, communication process occur two persons. Whereas in the group dynamic communication process, the communication process occurs more than two persons, and also it is limited to a group. When compared to the group dynamic communications, the public or mass communications, it aimed at larger group of people. Whereas when you come to organizational communications, it is within the organizations. The communication flow may be top to bottom or in the reverse mode, like bottom to top. When you come to cross-cultural communications, it is a communication between the culture or religion or group of people, where there is a exchange of idea between the group of peoples in relation. Now let us see the what do you mean by theories and models. Theories, a way of framing an experience or event, an effort to understand and account for something and the way it functions in the world. Whereas when you come to model, it is a representative form, style, or pattern. A model is thus a schematic description of a system, theory, or phenomenon that accounts for its known or inferred properties, and it may be used for further study of its characteristics. There are different communication theories evolved over the period of times. Gorick proposed seven different traditions of communication theory and outlines how each one of them would engage the others in dialogue. The first one is rhetorical theory. The next one is semiotic theory. The third one is phenomenological theory. The fourth one is cybernetic theory. The next one is socio-psychological theory. The other one is socio-cultural theory. The last one is critical theory. Corax, who have created with first formal rhetorical theory, he wrote a treatise called The Art of Rhetoric. In his treatise, he highlighted the importance of probability to rhetoric. A speaker should argue from the general probabilities to create a probable connection or basis for belief when actual facts cannot be established. Rhetorical theory now addresses all contexts in which symbol use occurs. Today, this means studying everything from intrapersonal to interpersonal to public discourse to social movements and a mediated discourse. Rhetorical theories addresses what makes public personal diary as rhetoric and televisions, the internet and website as rhetorical artifacts. This means that rhetorical theory also includes the study of visual or non-verbal element, such as study of art and architecture, building and all design elements of cities, and dress and appearance to sports, to name only a few. The next theory is semiotics. Semiotics is the science of communication and sign systems. Although natural and artificial languages are therefore central to semiotics, its field covers all non-verbal signaling and extends to domains whose communicated decision is perceived only unconsciously. Knowledge, meaning, intention, and action are fundamental concepts in the semantic investigation of phenomena. Now let us see the phenomenological theorist emphasize that each person actively construct his or his own world. According to phenomenological approach to personality, the special way each person perceives and interprets the world makes personality and guide one's own behavior. Carl Rogers' self theory and Abraham Maslow behavioral theory are comes under this category. The next is cybernetic theory. In the year 1948, Norbert Wiener coined the term cybernetic. According to Wiener, the basic functions of communication as a processing of information, a control the environment in which one lives. He defines the problem with the communication in terms of control and system malfunctions through the understanding of cybernetic theory. Wiener introduces the idea of entropy and feedback into the theory. The next one is, let us see the socio-psychological theory. Socio-psychology is a branch of psychology that studies the individual in the social context. This theory focuses the social behaviors and gives considerable insight into the individual and society and into the human conditions. George Herbert Mead, Herbert Plumer were work on this area. Social exchange theories emphasize the idea that social action is the result of personal choices made in order to maximize the benefit and minimize the cost. The key component of this theory is the postulation of the comparison level of alternative, which is actor's sense of best possible alternative related to cost. Next, socio-cultural theory. Socio-cultural theory is an emerging theory in psychology that looks at the important contribution that society makes to individual development. This theory stresses the interaction between people and the culture in which they live. Lev Vygotsky, who believed that parents, caregivers, peers, and the culture at large were responsible for the development of higher order functions. The last theory is the critical theory. The critical theory, who first propounded by Max Horkheimer in the year 1937 in the essay Traditional and Critical Theory. Critical theory questions the challenges of convictions that what is or what is in the process of becoming, or what happens to be, or what is most commonly understood to be, what is dominantly conveyed to be, is also at the same time right and true, good and just, and necessary and inevitable. Inspired by development in system theory and cybernetics, in the year 1949, Shannon and Weaver formulated a new communication model that is called information theory. In the information theory, the information is viewed as a measure of entropy or answer uncertainty in the system. The information theory model focuses on the nodes such as speakers and hearers. There are many models of communications developed by noted theorists of different disciplines, among Aristotle, Laswell, Shannon, Weaver, McLuhan, Rillis, Wesley, Scrimmon, Oslo, Ascot, Johnson, Cherry are the renowned ones. Aristotle, a great philosopher, developed a communication model is known as Aristotle model of communication. Aristotle, in his model of communications, framed with three basic elements. One is speaker, the other one is speech, the third one is audience. This model is more focused on public speaking than the interpersonal communications. There are three types of communication models are recognized. The first one is linear model. The second one is interactive model. The third one is the transactional model. Now let us see each one in detail process in which the speaker speaks and the listener listens. It is one way model to communicate with others. It consists of the sender encoding a message and channelizing it to the receiver in the presence of noise. The drawback of this model is that linear model assumes that there is a clear-cut beginning and end to communications. It also displays no feedback from the receiver. Now let us see the interactive model. This means the main flaw in the linear model is that it depicts communication as one-way process where speaker only speak and never listen. It also implies that listener listen and never speak or send message. Scrimmon, 1955, Ascot, 2009, came out with a more interactive model that saw the receiver or listener providing feedback to the sender or speaker. The speaker or sender of the message also listened to the feedback given by the receiver or the listener. Both speaker and the listener take turns to speak and listen to each other. Feedback is given either verbally or non-verbally or in both ways. This model is also indicate that the speaker and listener communicate better if they have common field of experience or field which overlaps. This is two linear model stacked on top of each other. The sender channels a message to the receiver and the receiver then becomes the sender and channels a message to the original sender. This model has added feedback, indicates that communication is not one way but two way process. There is a feedback but it is not simultaneous. The next one is transactional model. The main drawback in the interactive model is that it does not indicate the communication can both send and receive message simultaneously. This model also failed to show that communication is a dynamic process which changes over the time. The transactional model shows that elements in communication are interdependent. Each person in the communication act is both a speaker and a listener. and can be simultaneously sent and receiving message. There are three implications in transactional model. Number one, transactional means that communication is an ongoing and continuous changing process. Number two, in any transactional process, each element exists in relation to all other elements. The third one is each person in the communication process reacts depending on factors such as the background, prior experiences, attitudes, cultural beliefs, and self-esteem. These models also labels each communicator as both sender as well as the receiver simultaneously. Now let us see each model in detail. Laswell model of communications. An American political science and communication theorist, Harold Laswell, in the year 1948, wrote that a convenient way to describe an act of communication following question: who says what, in which channel, to whom, with what effect, to linear model. She follows Aristotle's rhetoric in his model, adding channel or medium. Laswell's 5 W's verbal model suggests that the message flow in the multicultural society with multiple audience. The flow of message is through various channels. Though this model is found to be easy and simple, suits for almost all type of communication, all the concept of effects. The major drawbacks are feedback and noise are not mentioned being a linear model. Now let us see the Shannon and Weaver model of communication. The first major model for communication came in 1949 by Claude Elwood Shannon and Warren Weaver for Bell Laboratories. This laid the foundation for different communication models and has greatly helped to enhance the communication process in various fields. The main features of this model include: it is a linear process, a simple model technically, content message is easy to identify but hard to solve, source is dominant factor or decision maker, noise a disturbing factor. The next model of communications, Theodore Newcomb's model of communication. Theodore M. Newcomb of the University of Michigan in the year 1953 published a new social approach in the field of communication, which is called ABX system. Later it became Newcomb model. Sometimes it is called as an ABX model of communication, as it works in a triangular format or ABX system. The main purpose of this theory is to introduce the role of communication in a social relationship and to maintain social equilibrium within the social system. In this model, it does not include message as a separate entity in his diagram, implying it only by use of directional arrows. He concentrates on the social purpose of communications, showing all communication as a means of sustaining relationship between people. The next model which we can see about George Herbner's model of communication. Mr. George Herbner is a professor and head of Annenberg School of Communication, the University of Pennsylvania. He is one of the pioneers in the field of communication research. In the year 1956, Herbner attempted the general purpose of communication models. He stressed that the dynamic nature of communication in his work and also factors affecting the reliability of communications. In this model, two dimensions are there, namely perceptual dimension and means and control dimensions. The perceptual dimensions, as given in the figure, an A is an event happened in the real life, and the event content or message is perceived by M. M may be man or a machine. After perception, the message from E by M is also as E1. E1 is not same as like E, because any man or machine cannot perceive the whole event, and they perceive only the part of E1, that is E1. Because any man or machine cannot perceive the whole event, and they perceive only the part of E1, that is E1. This is known as perceptual dimension. The factors involved between E and M are selection, context, and availability. M cannot perceive the entire content of the event E, so M select the interesting or needed from the entire event and filtering the others. The context occur in the event, and the availability is based on M's attitude, mood, culture, and personality. When you come to means and control dimension, E2 is the event content which is drawn by M. Here M becomes the source of message about E to send someone else. M creates a statement or signal about a message, and Herbner termed its form and content as SE2. S is signal or form. It takes an E2, man's content. Here, content E2 is structured or formed S by M, and it can communicate in a different ways or based on the structured ways. M has to use channels or media over to send the message which has a greater or lesser degree of control. The question of control relates to M's degree of skill in using communication channel. If he using a verbal channel, how good is he using words? If he using the internet, how good is he at using new technology and words? This process can be extended to infinitum by adding other receivers, that is M2, M3, etc., who have further perception, SE2, SE4, etc., of the statements about perceived events. The next two model which we can see here, David Berlow model of communications. Another famous communication model is Berlow's model. In this model, he stresses on the relationship between the person sending the message and the receiver. Berlow's source, message, channel, and receiver model has four main components, and each component has its own subcomponents describing the assisting factor for each. This is mentioned in the figure. Number one here is source. The source is where the message originates. Within that, we have communication skill subcomponent. Attitude is another component. Knowledge is another component. Social system is another subcomponent. Culture is another subcomponent. The last one, this category, is encoded. Communication skills is the individual skills to communicate, such as ability to read, write, speak, listen, etc. When you come to attitude, the attitude towards the audience, subject, and towards oneself. The knowledge about the subject one is going to communicate, for example, whatever the teacher communicate in the class about the subject, so having knowledge in what you are communicating. Social system includes the various aspects in a society like values, beliefs, culture, religion, and general understanding of society. It is where the communication takes place. Culture of given society also comes under the social system. The last subcomponent is encoded. The sender of the message is referred as encoded. So the source is encoding the message here. The next component is message. It refers to the subject matter under transfer. The subcomponents are content, elements, treatment, structure. The content, a message, comprises of its content. Content is accompanied by some elements. Elements includes various things like language, gestures, body language, etc. So these are all the elements of a particular message. Treatment refers to the packing of message, the way in which the message is conveyed, or the way in which the message is passed on or delivered. The structure of the message is how it is arranged or sequenced. The last subcategory of this message category, the code. The code of message means how it sent, in what form it could be. For example, language, body language, gesture, music, and even culture is a code. Through this, you give the message, or through which the communication takes place or being reached. The third component is channel. It refers to five senses, which are hearing, seeing, touching, smelling, and tasting. Whenever communication we do, it is there either of these channels. Despite not mentioning a medium, we need to assume that as a communication is taking place, channel can be any of the five senses or combinations. The last component in this model is receiver. The receiver needs to have all the things like the source, and he is referred to as a decoder who receives the message and decodes it. This model believes that for an effective communication to take place, the source and the receiver needs to be in the same level. Only if the source and receiver are on the same level of communication will happen or take place properly. So source and receiver should be similar. For example, communication skill on source side is good, then the receiver should equally have a good listening skill. The last model which we are going to see here is Davis-Fackler model. Fackler introduced his ecological model in 2002 and reconstructed it in the year 2004. It is a model, more detailed elaboration of Laswell's classical outline of study of communication. The fundamental statement of relationship establishes a series of general relationships between people, message, language, media, and the communication they enable. In the figure given in the Davis-Fackler model, communication between people creator and consumer is mediated by three constructs, with the language used to build messages within media. The model graphically depicts all of the propositions described above. Especially it depicts people communicating through the mediation of the message that are created and consumed using language within the media. Let me summarize this model with that models are fundamental building blocks of theory. They are also a fundamental tool for instructions. Chanon and Weaver information theory model, Weiner's cybernetic model, and Hertz two-step flow, each allowed scholar to decompose the process of communication into discrete structural elements. Each provides the basis for considerable body of communication theory and research. Each model also provides teacher with a powerful pedagogical tool for teaching students to understand that communication is a complex process in which many things can and frequently do go wrong. For teaching students the way in which they can perfect different skills at different point, and communication process became more effective communicator. Thank you.